HIV and AIDS have both physical and nutrition implications that can lead to malnutrition and threaten a person's life. In this video, we will explain the pathophysiology of the infection, identify symptoms and health implications that occur, and relate complications to the high risk of malnutrition that typically occurs. HIV infection is characterized by destruction of the person's immune system, so they cannot fight off infection. The virus destroys white T cells in your immune system. Once a person's T cell count is below a certain level, then AIDS, known as acquired immunodeficiency syndrome, has begun. In other words, AIDS is considered to be advanced stage HIV infection. This is when a person will start developing serious life-threatening diseases and infections. Depletion of T cells reduces the body's resistance to infectious diseases. Within a few weeks of HIV infection, a person may develop flu-like symptoms such as fever, sore throat, and fatigue. These symptoms will go away, and often the person has no idea that they are infected unless they get a blood test for HIV. After initial symptoms, the disease is often asymptomatic until it progresses to AIDS, which on average can take about 7 to 10 years without medication. AIDS symptoms include weight loss, fever, night sweats, fatigue, and recurrent infections. With aggressive drug therapy, the individual with HIV is susceptible to a condition called lipodystrophy, where fat shifts from places like the face and arms to breasts, back of the neck, and abdomen. Hyperlipidemia, such as high cholesterol and triglycerides, along with impaired glucose tolerance occur, and combined with body composition changes caused by medication, can significantly increase the risk of health problems such as cardiovascular disease, hypertension, and insulin resistance or type 2 diabetes. There are many potential complications that occur as the HIV infection progresses. It seems to affect all body systems. One of the first places you see visual signs of HIV is on the skin. A weakened immune response leaves a person more vulnerable to viruses such as herpes, which can cause lesions in both the mouth and genitals. Technically, since immunity is so weak with HIV infection, the person is at very high risk for all types of infections and infectious diseases. But pulmonary infections are the most dangerous, especially as the disease advances. Respiratory infections are often the cause of death for a person with AIDS. As the gastrointestinal system declines, the individual experiences frequent diarrhea, malabsorption, and nutrient deficiencies that cause muscle loss, bone softening, and anemia. HIV complications from early onset to the end can interfere with eating that leads to malnutrition. Oral infections are very common, which occur due to the weak immune system. Thrush, shown in the picture on the right, is a yeast infection of the mouth that makes eating painful. Sores can also develop in the mouth and on the lips, and often are chronic viral infections such as herpes. Oral lesions are among the early symptoms of HIV infection. People infected with HIV are at very high risk of Kaposi sarcoma, which is a cancer that develops from the cells that line lymph or blood vessels. Kaposi sarcoma can also result in tumors that grow inside the mouth. In addition to mouth sores and infections, many other things can affect eating with HIV, such as reduced appetite or food tasting bad. Nausea and vomiting are common side effects of the medications used to treat the virus. Fatigue and psychological issues such as depression, fear, and anxiety can also interfere with eating. AIDS can affect the intestines and cause severe diarrhea. This can impact their quality of life and also lead to life-threatening fluid and electrolyte imbalances, further aggravating malnutrition. As you can tell by the complications, malnutrition due to poor food intake and malabsorption is quite high in the end stages. As you think forward, consider how nutrition therapy will differ for someone who is malnourished in the later stages compared to earlier in the disease, where medications are causing concerns with lipodystrophy, heart disease, and insulin resistance. Also consider how a lowered immune system will affect food choices, food preparation, and where one eats.